Yeah, good morning students. Today we discuss the concept of data pre-processing. The data pre-processing is in data mining and data science, data mining and data science, what are the current technologies and machine learning concepts. Today the data pre-processing is a vital role in the data mining to extract the knowledge in the same as the data science concept and machine learning concept. So what is called a data pre-processing? So different types of data pre-processing techniques. One is data cleaning. Data integration and data transformation. So these are the different types of data and other techniques also there, data pre-processing techniques. Data cleaning, why should we need to clean the data? So because, so data is a, when you are collecting, data can be collected manually, manually collection and using a data collection tools. Sometimes maybe the data is come up with a noise. Data come up with a noise and in the data some values are missing, missing values and erroneous data. There is a possibility. So the data cleaning is most important in the data pre-processing, to clean the data, to remove the noise, to remove the noise, to remove the missing value. Is not a random process. To remove the missing value means to fill the missing value with manually, to fill the missing value with the global value, to fill the missing value with the mean value, to fill the missing value with the median, and to remove the errorness also we can use some mathematical measure, we can remove the errorness data. So after data cleaning, there is a data integration is there. In the data integration, whether the attributes, maybe some redundancies are there. Redundancy can be detected using a data integration. In the data integration, with the numerical attributes and categorical attributes are there. One important statistical measure is there for a data integration, whether the attributes are correlated or not. There is a correlation is a different type. So in the data integration, the concept of data integration, we can detect the redundancies can be detected in the attributes, when the attributes are correlated or there is a correlated or not. In the correlated or not, it's a good statistical measure using a chi-square analysis. Chi-square analysis, the chi-square formula, sigma I equal to 1 to, I equal to 1 to C, there is a column, and sigma J equal to 1 to R row, O I J minus E I J whole square by E I J. Whereas O I J is observed frequency, E I J is expected frequency. So here we can, the chi square, whether the attributes are correlated or not. We can detect there is a correlation existed or not between the attributes or not. So for, we have to find the, what is the observed frequency, we have to find the, from that we have to find the expected frequency. From that there is a, after whatever the chi square value, the chi square value, computed value compared with statistical table value. What are the statistical table values, the chi-square statistical tables are available, whether it is greater than, whether it is greater than or less than, right? So I can take one example, very good example. There is a survey conducted. So the chi-square can be applied anywhere. Suppose the survey, the political surveys are conducted, the political opinions, or maybe any product opinion, the product good or not. The product is relevant to trends. Suppose maybe in the festival season, in the festival season, like e-commerce, the sales are depend on any festival. Suppose in Andhra Pradesh, maybe Pongal. pongal, there is a sales. It really depends on the sale on the pongal or not. Maybe the trend, there is called trend analysis, like e-commerce, like Amazon and Flipkart, right? And we can take any example. Suppose there is no relation, whereas a positive correlation means like this. This is a positive correlation. That means, suppose you have x-axis, it is a y-axis. So the value x-axis increases, y also increases. There is a positively correlated. Whereas a negatively correlated, this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, like this. There is x value increases, the y value decreases. So the objects are scattered like this. The objects are scattered like this. There is no correlation. No correlation means all are independent. All are independent attributes, there is no dependence. So that is the importance of correlation. Whether the attributes are dependent or independent. Suppose in the political surveys, suppose the government, maybe some welfare schemes. The welfare schemes are dependent in politically the party won or not. So is there any dependency or not? The same, a good example, in the United States of America, the different novels. So the United States of America, the novel type may be fiction and non-fiction novels. Is there any dependence on the gender? Gender is different types, male and female. Maybe there is any correlation, the type of novel depends on the gender. Suppose novels, the males are interested to read that novels. Some maybe stories, the female candidate, they are interested to read. So there is a survey conducted, is there any correlation between the novel type and gender type? So I can take an example. So I can take one example, very good example, in a 2x2 contingency table, fiction and non-fiction, fiction and non-fiction and male, there is 250, these are all observed frequencies, and 50, there is a male people and female. 200 female and 1000 and reading non-fiction hours. The total fiction hours 450 and non-fiction hours read by male and female total 1250, and here the total male are 300 and here the female people are 1200. The total both the columns 1500. See that the total male survey are conducted on the total male 300, the survey conducted on female 1200, the total 1500 population, and out of 1500 population 450 people including male and female, they are interested to read fiction novel, and 50 male and 1000 female people, male and female, they are reading, interested to read non-fiction novel. Now we have to find the chi-square value. What is the chi-square value? The chi-square equal to observed frequency sigma I equal to 1 to rho, sigma j equal to 1 to c, oij minus eij whole square by eij. Observed frequency we know. What are the value of observed frequencies? So now we have to find the expected frequency value, Eij value. So now we can find the Eij value. What is the Eij? Eij equivalent to count of male, count of male into simple, the formula equal to Eij equal to count of a equal to ai attribute ai value into count of b equal to bj by n, n equal to number of samples. Suppose eij, the first row, row value, this one. What is the expected frequency of this one? So expected frequency of that E11, Eij, I equal to 1, first row, first column. The count of A equal to Aj, that means count of male into count of fixen, male and fixen, count of fixen by, so n equal to number of samples are 1500 and n value. See, E11 equal to count of male equal to 250 into count of fixen novel, data fixen novels are 450, 250 into 450 by 1500, 00 cancel and 250 into 45, 1545, 3 times, I think 3250 is 6 and 350 is 850, sorry 300, count of male, sorry count of male, total count of male, sorry count of male 300, total 300 into 450, 00 cancel, 1545, 3 and 3, 30 is 90. So the now the expected frequency of male and fixen novels 90. Right. So next continuation E12. E12. So E11 is over. Sorry, fixen and non-fixen. Count of male and count of fixen. Now E12, count of female, count of female, count of female 200, sorry count of female 1200 into count of fixen, total 450 by 90. 95, sorry, 1500, this is the n value, 1500, 00 cancel and 00 cancel, 1545, 3 times, 3120, 360, exactly 360. So 3 120 is 360. So now E12 is over. Then second row first column E21 equal to E21 count of male. Count of male is 300 into count of non-fixen novels 1250 count of male and count of non-fixen novels by 1500. Then again for calculation 00 cancel, 00 cancel, 1530, 2 times, 2125, sorry small correction, E21 count of male, count of male, count of fixen, count of male, count of fixen is over, count of male, count of fixen is over, count of male and non-fixen, count of male 300 and non-fixen number 1250 by 1500, 00 cancel and 00 cancel, There is a count of female U22 equal to count of total female 1200 into non-fiction hours total 1250 by 1500 00 yeah sorry actually the correction is here I think 1050 actually 50 plus 1000 this is not 1250 1050 make it correct actually 450 1050 I am writing instead of 012 that is the correction that is the reason we are getting wrong outputs E21 E22 here the value is 1050 the total value should be 1500 at the column wise and row wise 300 and 1200 1500 and 450 1250 means 1250 1300 1700 actually so it is a wrong value the total population is 1500 the survey conducted on 1500 people so there is a correction so make it correct not 1250 1050 that is the reason I'm getting wrong value so now 1050 so 00 cancel 00 cancel 15 2 so 105 210 this is the value is 210 again 1050 into 1050 non-fiction hour and female people 1200 1050 into 1200 1050 non-fiction total non-fiction hour 1050 and female 1200 by total population is 1500 00 cancel 00 cancel I think 15 105 95 or 45 8 5 3 times and 105 21 times 3 again 21 7 times 700 720 14 and 717 840 so the value is 840 so now we computed all the expected frequency values 90 300 and 210 and 840 now we have non-fiction now we are having oij values and eij values observed frequency values and expected frequency values so both the values what are the chi square analysis equal to sigma I equal to 1 to j equal to sigma j equal to 1 to r oij minus eij by eij that is the chi square analysis formula oij minus eij whole square by eij now we have oij we are having oij values and eij values we can substitute in the formula so chi square value equivalent to chi square equivalent to oij observed frequency 250 so 250 minus 90 whole square by what is the expected frequency value 90 there is a sigma that is the reason sum of the values and next 50 observed frequency expected frequency is 210 50 minus 210 whole square by expected frequency 210 plus 200 minus 200 minus 3 what is the value 200 minus 360 whole square by expected frequency 360 plus 1000 minus 840 whole square by 840 So these are chi square values. After finding the values, the final value equivalent to, there is a, actually the calculator is required to compute the values. So directly I am giving the value. You can use your calculator. You can calculate these values because the values are big. I cannot compute the values in the manual process. Right? The values are 250 minus 90 whole square. The value equivalent to 284.44 plus 2121.90 plus 71.11 plus 30.48. Finally, we will get the value is 507.93. So you can use your calculator, you can compute the values. We can't do here. The total value, the chi square value is 507.93. So compare this value from the statistical table. Actually, the statistical table, the degree of freedom, equal to R minus 1 into C minus 1, row minus 1 into column minus 1. It is a 2 cross 2 contingency matrix. That is a row minus 1, 2 minus 1, and column minus 1, 2 minus 1. We will get the value is 1. So the total population is 1500. So you can check the value in the 4 decimal points 1000, so like 0.001. So in the step from the statistical table, the 0 at 0.001, 507.93, from the statistical table, what is the value is 10.828. So one thing you remember it, here the degree of freedom, row minus 1 into column minus 1, it is a 2 cross 2 contingency matrix. Suppose if it is a 4 cross 4, suppose 4 minus 1 into 4 minus 1, the 3 cross 3, 9. You can check 9 means 0.009. You can check in the statistical table at 0.009, what is the value of 507.93. Now, what is the value of 0.001, the computed value of the chi square value 507.93 in the statistical table, 10.828. That means 507.93 is greater than 10.828. Actually, our hypothesis are both are independent. The reading of novel, the gender, both are independent. There is no dependency between the novel reading and novel type and gender type. Gender type, male and female, both are independent, our hypothesis. Now, the value is, our computed value is greater than the statistical value. So, the hypothesis is rejected. So, that means there is a computed value is greater than means there is a positively correlated. Positively correlated. That means the gender type dependent, or both are dependent, gender and novel type. Maybe you have a doubt, why sir this is calculation, gender and novel reading, it is important in application point. Yes, exactly. Suppose suppose in a newspaper, suppose in our area, Vishakhapatnam, Hyderabad, circulated a newspaper, maybe based on how many of people they are reading the particular newspaper. Suppose in the Vishakhapatnam, the total population is maybe 10,000. Around 10,000, maybe greater than 3,000 people are reading, interested in your newspaper, then the circle, okay, it is profitable. And suppose maybe more than 10,000 people are interested to read your newspaper, so you increase the publishing, increase the product publishing. The same as the different other books are releasing in the market, so the people are suppose Wings of Fire, Abdul Kalam, the great the President of India, suppose the people are reading to interest to read that book, so the publisher to increase the publication printing, increase to more release into the market, because both are depend, because of more young age people or maybe all age people they are interested to read, right? So that here gender and fiction and novel are dependent. Maybe the female people read more non-fiction novel. Suppose in any particular area, suppose Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, female people are more. Female people are more. In Hyderabad, the total population is just assumption, 20,000. In out of 20,000, maybe 15,000 are female. 15,000 are female. So 15,000 females are their interest to read non-fiction novel. So obviously the publisher, so increase the number of books in the publication point of view. So that is the importance of chi-square analysis and we can find the duplicate values also. So whether the correlation or not, whether attributes are dependent or independent, we can find. So this is the one part of data preprocessing. What are the different steps in the data preprocessing? Data cleaning, then data integration, then data transformation, then data reduction. So next class, we will continue. After data integration, we will discuss data transformation. Thank you.